Hello one and all, I, Archana Saeed, going to demonstrate the concept of recursion in C++. Let's start with the definition. When a function is called within the same function, it is known as recursion. The process in which a function calls itself is known as recursion, and the corresponding function is called as a recursive function. The good example to demonstrate the concept of recursion is calculating the factorial of a given number. So let's proceed with the program. In this program, through main, I have called a function which is named as f, and to calculate the factorial of n equal to 4, the recursive function is f integer n. N less than or equal to 1 is the base condition. Otherwise, the function is called recursively by decrementing the value of integer n by 1. So through main, f of n is called as called to a factorial function. Then it goes to the function definition. Based on the base condition, either if part or the else part will be executed. Whenever you give any program for the execution, its entry is made into the internal stack. The entry point for C++ program is main function. Its entry is made into the internal stack. The next line of execution is f of n, that is function call. Its entry is also made into the function call with a given parameter. For this function call, the parameter value is 4, that's why the entry is 4. Now, how this internally works, let's proceed for that. So as you can see, I have written the function definition over here, and value n is equal to 4 that we have passed to this program. So for the very first time, the function will be called with n equal to 4. If part will be checked, as this condition is not true, only the else part will be executed, meaning 4 into f of 4 minus 1, that is 3. So again, this f of 3 is a recursive function that will be called. It will again go into the function definition. Condition will be checked. The condition is not true, so only else part will be executed. And in else part, the value is n, that is 3, f into bracket 2 minus 1. 3 minus 1, that is 2. So again, f of 2 is the recursive call. This function is expanded with n equal to 2. So 2 is not less than or equal to 1, meaning else part will be executed. So else will be 2 into f of 2 minus 1, that is f of 1. Now here, f of 1 is the recursive call. This function will be expanded as if n less than or equal to 1. Now in this condition, 1 is the value of n. So the if condition is true. If 1 is less than or equal to 1, this condition is true, so it will return value as 1. So where it will return? It will return from where this function is called. This function is called from this particular location. So this f of 1 function call will be replaced by 1. So 2 into 1, the result 2 will be returned. Now where it will return? It will be returned from where it has been called. So 2 into 1 will be replaced by this f of 2 as a function call. So at this particular stage, 3 into 2, 6 will be calculated, and it will be returned from its calling point. So this f of 3 is replaced by 6. So 6 into 4, 24 is the result that will be returned from where it has been called. It has been called from the very first function call, that is 4. So here for n equal to 4, the value which we are getting as 24, that is in the mean. So again we'll go back to the PPT. So n equal to 4, that is the function call. Recursively the functions are expanded by checking every time the value of n. This is the base condition, n less than or equal to 1. As n reaches to 1, the value 1 will be returned from where it has been called. So it is going to return every time by returning the result of multiplication. So how this can be used? See, suppose this is the internal stack. So the first entry is obviously main. The next entry was f of 4. From f of 4, f of 3 we have called. From f of 3, f of 2, and from f of 2 we have called f of 1. So this f of 1 is going to return one value to f of 2. So f of 2 will be 2 into 1. So the result 2 will be returned to f of 3. In f of 3, 3 into 2, 6 result will be returned to 4 into f of 4. And finally, to this f of 4, 24 is the result that we are going to get. So this is how the recursive calls are getting executed with the help of internal stack memory, which is a part of main memory, to get the factorial of a given number. So the advantage of recursion is the number of lines of code are getting decreased as compared to the iterative example. Thank you.